Hello, I'm Joseph Richmond from the TGA, Tobacco Growers of America, and I have some startling news for you about lung cancer. For too long now, the American public has lived under a gross misconception that smoking tobacco causes lung cancer. Well, we at the TGA deplore this, for it is deception, and tonight would like to make the real truth known. There is no denying that lung cancer is messy and inconvenient, but to blame it on cigarettes is specious and ill-founded. Can we really blame this for death? Let's examine it. We have the outer covering, paper. Paper is derived from trees. You don't see warnings on trees, do you? And in the belly, we have 100% pure tobacco straight from the earth, Mother Earth, where flowers grow and children frolic. And people think this kills. This is a delicate object. It's so weak, I can crush it with my bare hands. Look at the way it fights back, huh? Some murderer. Clearly it is not the poor cigarette that causes lung cancer. It's the lung. Let's take a look at this lemon. No wonder people die. It's got a cockamamie shape. It's way too little. It's filled with mucus. It's flimsy. It's clammy. And for the life of me, I don't know how anything gets in and out of that pathetic little hole. Really? If they work so well, why do you need two? It's clear where the fault lies. The lung has one job, to get rid of a little smoke. And does it do it? No. The lung traps the smoke on purpose. Keeps it. My 7-year-old daughter's fan can blow a little smoke away, but that's too much for poor old Mr. Lung. This, as you can well understand, is a serious problem. And so the FDA has taken serious action. The lung must be recalled. So old persons with lungs shall send them to Lungs. 30 Rockefeller Plaza, New York, New York, 10020. Persons without lungs need not worry. Thank you.